As all of you probably know, the Percy Jackson and the Olympian books are getting their own Disney Plus TV series. This is well deserved, as Percy Jackson is a very beloved series with a ton of fans who have in the past been let down by adaptions. Now that Disney Plus is taking on the job of adapting the Percy Jackson books with the help of author Rick Riordan, fans are hopeful that they will be able to make this series accurate to the books. In Fox's Percy Jackson movies, some of the casting choices for characters were a bit off, some characters barely even representing the actual character at all. There are quite a few characters in the Percy Jackson books, so this is going to be a series. As the main demigods are supposed to be 12 years old, I'm going to say that they need to be unknown kids. Instead of doing them, we are going to be casting only characters who are older. In this video, we are going to be casting the Greek gods of Olympus. So let's hop straight into it. To start off, we have Zeus, the king of Olympus and the god of thunder and lightning. Zeus doesn't exactly have the biggest part in Percy Jackson, but as he is Zeus, he's a very important character to the story. Zeus, as the king of the gods, is very proud, commanding, and has an extremely high amount of self-respect. In order for the character to be played well, we need to see a big person who looks as if they can be a leader. We need someone who really stands out and that can hold a face and posture of a guy you wouldn't want to mess with. I believe that the best choice for this character would have to be Jason Momoa. Jason Momoa comes in at 6'4 and is a huge man that has the look of dominance that I was looking for. He is 41 years old, so he is in the age range that I was looking for when it comes to most of the gods. He also looks somewhat like the illustrations of Zeus. I think he has been great in his past roles, and I think he would be exactly what we need for this character. So Jason Momoa as Zeus. Next we have Poseidon, the god of the sea. This part is very important, as Poseidon is Percy Jackson's dad. Even though he shares many characteristics with Zeus, including pride, stubbornness, and a fearsome temper, he appears to have matured over the centuries to a point where these attributes do not dominate Poseidon to the same extent they do Zeus, making him much more reasonable. Poseidon has a more caring and overall human personality. He also plays a somewhat decent but awkward dad to Percy. Poseidon needs to look like an older version of Percy, and I think I have the perfect idea. I believe that the best choice for the character would have to be Logan Lerman. Logan Lerman in the past, of course, played Percy Jackson, so this would be a very cool way to bring him back to the universe. He looks exactly how he should. The only thing that I'm not quite sure about is how young he looks, but you can always make him look older and more grizzled. I think that Logan Lerman is a great actor and that he could really do the role justice. So Logan Lerman as Poseidon. Next we have Hades, the ruler of the underworld. For Hades, I wanted someone who looked somewhat close to the last two people I casted because they are the big three brothers. I also wanted to cast somebody who looked like they could take on a more evil and creepy side. For this, I chose Tom Ellis. He isn't the most well-known actor, but I think he is a pretty good one, and I think he could work wonders in the role of Hades. So Tom Ellis as Hades. For the rest of the characters, I'm going to be a bit more quick with them, so let's go. For Ares, I picked Tom Hardy. I picked Tom Hardy because of his role in Venom. I really feel like he can play that tough guy who comes off as a jerk. He also fits the physical appearance that I was looking for. So Tom Hardy as Ares. For Hermes, I picked Chris Pratt. I really feel like Chris Pratt could really bring that charm and funny side of Hermes, kind of like what we saw in the Sea of Monsters movie. He also looks exactly how I myself would envision Hermes, so Chris Pratt as Hermes. For Aphrodite, I picked Margot Robbie. I picked her because she is not only good looking, but she also resembles Annabeth in looks. In The Titan's Curse, Percy says that when he saw Aphrodite, she resembled Annabeth. Margot Robbie also is a very good actor, and I feel like she would do really well in this role. So Margot Robbie as Aphrodite. For Athena, I picked Alexandria Daddario. I think she would be great in this role, and it would be a great way to bring her back to the Percy Jackson universe. Just like Logan Lerman played Percy, I casted him as Percy's dad. Alexandria played Annabeth, so I feel like it would be right for her to play her mom. Alexandria also fits the look of Athena better than the look of Annabeth. So Alexandria Daddario as Athena. For Hera, I picked Lena Olin. She isn't the most well-known actress, but she definitely has a motherly look, but she also looks kind of like a bitch, which fits Hera perfectly. So Lena Olin as Hera. For Demeter, I picked Nicole Kidman. I picked her because I thought she fit the role pretty well, but she won't really have to get up to much acting. So Nicole Kidman as Demeter. For Artemis, I picked Mackenzie Foy because she shows the youth of Artemis pretty well and I can just really see her playing this part. So Mackenzie Foy as Artemis. For Apollo, I picked Tom Holland because he is in good shape and in good youth, and I feel like if you dyed Tom's hair blonde, he could do great in the role. So Tom Holland as Apollo. For Hephaestus, I picked David Harbour. I picked him because he has a good grizzled and strong look, and I really think he fits what I was looking for in the character. So Tom Harbour as Hephaestus. And lastly, for Dionysus, I picked Jack Black, as I think he would work wonders in this role. I feel like Jack Black can really take on the mean side of Dionysus, but also make him a more funny and comedic relief type of character, but also keep him the same grumpy Mr. D that we all know and love. I also think Jack Black fits the look perfectly, so Jack Black as Dionysus. And that wraps up the casting of the gods. I know that some of them were more A-list actors, but since the show is coming from Disney, and the roles they would have to play would only require them to show up a couple times, I really do think it's possible to get some of these actors and actresses to play the role. Stay tuned for the next video in this series where I will be casting more characters from Percy Jackson. If you enjoyed this video, consider leaving a like and subscribing to the channel. We are on our way to hitting 1,000 subscribers, so let's see if we can hit it before the end of 2020. Thanks for watching, everyone, and I'll see you in the next video.